I see one right off the bat. Doesn't look like anyone's landing here either. Nice. So here's one right next to the vault. No way. Alright, so as you can see, we've got ourselves a whole bunch of new quests, including the Ghostbusters Afterlife Challenges. It says, earn rewards by completing the Ghostbusters Afterlife quests. Nice. Then we have the Fort Nightmares. Join in the spooky action. Earn rewards for completing Fort Nightmares and Horde Rush quests. Nice. So you can see there's all sorts of rewards. We get sprays, pickaxes, contrails, gliders, backblings. So there's at least three new NPCs. Ariana Grande, Containment Specialist, and then Dark Jonesy has a new set as well. I thought there was Hollowhead, but I don't actually see him. I guess he's just the head of the Fort Nightmares event. No pun intended. So in this video, I'll just be doing the Ghostbusters Afterlife Challenges. So you can find this Ghostbuster all the way down here at Camp Cot. I'm sure it's going to be quite a hot drop, especially because these are all brand new. So let's see what the quests are, and we'll try to complete them and grab this, what I assume is a backbling, I think. So obviously we have to talk to the NPC first. Looks like he's in the northeast aspect of Camp Cot. Like I said, I imagine this is going to be a hot drop, but we'll see. Alright, it looks like the minimap was wrong, and he's over here, near the actual Ghostbusters mobile. Deploy seismographs in Misty Meadows or Caddy Corner. Alright, go ahead, get the challenge. I'll leave you be. So as you saw, he wasn't where the minimap said up here. And that's actually good for me because everyone landed there. He's actually down here near the Ghostbusters mobile. So I imagine these are going to not only light up blue, but light up on our minimap as well. So we should have no issue finding all three locations, but let's just confirm that here. There's a lot of things. Oh yeah, right there. I see one right off the bat. Doesn't look like anyone's landing here either. Nice. So here's one right next to the vault. No way. It played the Ghostbusters theme. Are you kidding me? That was amazing. Absolutely incredible. All right, the next one is right by the reboot van. Again, listen to this as soon as I place it. Here we go. Amazing. Now where is the third one at? Ah, it's right behind the garage. So fairly easy to find, all three of them. Here we go. Turn the volume up for this ghost-busting theme. Aw, the level up ruined it. Man. Alright, second stage. Exterminate mini puffs with a pickaxe in Sludgy Swamp, Lazy Lakes, or Retail Row. Mini puffs? That's like the Stay Puff Marshmallow Man. I can't wait! Oh, here's some mini puffs. Look at this right here. So in the blacktop buildings, oh, they're just floating. Ha! Oh, that is so cool. Okay, well, that was all three of them. Let's go. Now we have to retrieve mechanical parts by destroying cars. Well, that should be easy enough. We might be able to do that right here. I didn't know you could still get mechanical parts by destroying cars. Is that true? Wait, do I have to destroy it in full? Oh, okay, so you literally have to blow it up, and there's a piece right there. Nice. Five of them, holy smokes. I'll take that. Thank you very much. So just... What the? It flew all the way over there. Did you see that? So just shred as many cars as you can. So Retail Row is a good spot for this because you're gonna definitely find a million of them. Oh. It let me pick two of them up there. Nice. Oh, yeah, we can get candy out of here, too. All right, next stage says, place Ghostbuster signs in holly hedges, dirty docks, or Pleasant Park. Oh, man, well, all of those are completely gone from where I am, so we have to go to another match. Okay, so again, we have to place Ghostbuster signs in holly hedges, dirty docks, or Pleasant Park. It looks like dirty docks only has two, so I wouldn't go there. I would probably go holly or craggy, because hardly anyone goes to either of those as opposed to Pleasant Park. I think holly would be much easier to navigate than craggy, so I'm gonna go to holly. Let's find all three. Should be pretty easy. Wow, I just got a scar. Oh, look at that, right outside our front door. So right here is one in the southernmost house. Right here. Let's place that sign. Yes, it played the music again. I love it. Oh, here's another one right by this garage. So this is the northeastmost house in Holly Hedges. Oh, someone's in here too. Here we go. I want to show you on my map, but I don't want to die. Oh, it's a bot, I think. It is a bot. Okay, so that exact location is right here, the northeast. So we had one south, one northeast. Oh, the third one is in the smack dab center building, right in front there. Let's go place it and go on to the final challenge. So again, we had one right there, one on the south, and one on the northeast. Easy. All right, so the fifth and final stage of these Ghostbusters challenges says deploy a ghost trap. And look at all these places you can pick from. Now, luckily, if you went to Holly Hedges, right where you placed the sign, there's a ghost trap right there. Right there. There's also a guy right out here. So I gotta be careful. He's creeping. Let's see what happens when we place this. It's gonna be awesome. Let's go. Who's creeping over here? There he is. It's a superhero skin, of course. It was a bot the whole time? Come on! Well, there you go. That was so cool, and I didn't really even get to witness it because I was too scared about this bot! A literal bot, not hate intended. It was quite literally a bot creeping outside my room. Wow. All right, so what kind of rewards did we get for that? Well, the 100 V-Bucks was from the Drift Walker Challenge Pack, so ignore that. Here it is, though, the No Ghost Backbling. Unfortunately, though, it's just a holographic one, but it's still cool. It's the official Ghostbusters logo. However, the Ghostbuster skin already comes with two amazing backblings. You've got the trap, as well as the proton pack like I had been wearing. So I don't know if I would run this over either of those, but you could run this on another skin if you wanted. It's kind of cool. I do love that official logo though. So there you go. That's how you complete the Ghostbusters Afterlife challenges. Pretty easy, super fun. You even got the awesome, real, authentic Ghostbusters theme that plays briefly. Apparently they couldn't get the full copyrights, but they played it briefly and I'll take that any day of the week. So there you go. That's all there is to it. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. A like is always appreciated. And don't forget to use my supporter creator code, which is TaborTime.